You spend your life in a dream that you can't escape. Cause you live your life in a coma, you never awake. If you'd open your eyes, then maybe you'd see what's at stake. You're sleeping. You're sleeping.
I wake up the next morning. Today I'm Nathan Feuerstein. He lives in Gladwin, Michigan. Darkness surrounds his life. From what I gather from his memories, his mom died not too long ago from an overdose. How did she choose drugs over her kids? He needed her. His parents are divorced. He was abused by his mom's boyfriend and now lives with his dad and with his two sisters. His room is small and cluttered. I see he's a songwriter. Hundreds of notepads stacked on the desk, on the floor, and on his bed. The trash bin is overflowing with crumpled papers. I see his basketball shoes and a gym bag on the corner of his closet. Besides the basketball shoes, a crumpled note caught my attention, opening it saying, "I don't get it, Mom. Don't you want to watch your babies grow? I guess that pills are more important. All you have to say is no." Examining his room and the pictures on his walls, I noticed he doesn't really have any friends. One particular photo did stand out. It's a photo of his mom. Looking back at his past, his mind slowly fills with memories of the old days. Thinking of the times when his mom used to hold him. But now he lives through pain with voices in his head making him think twice. Nathan doesn't need the photo of his mom. He needs the real thing. He's been through a lot, and I felt it. Looking at the notes filled with lyrics, music was his only escape. On the right side of his desk, I see a karaoke machine. I'm guessing that's what he uses to record his songs. Stepping down the hall towards the bathroom, I see his two sisters still sleeping. I wonder if they're hurting as much as Nathan right now. Nathan's dad is already gone for work. He left a sticky note behind reminding Nathan to make lunches for the two girls. I started to explore the living room, then onto the kitchen. The house is small. It's dark and grimy. The window on the top of the couch shows the grass is struggling to stay green. It looks like no one has lived in here for a long time. Broken picket fences with the paint slowly fading away. Sirens can be heard from the distance. The neighborhood looks run down. I woke up the girls and got them ready for school, placing their lunches into their backpacks before grabbing their hands to take them to the bus stop. Before stepping out the door, I noticed a stack of CDs on the table. Glancing at it, Nathan's memories reminded me to hand them out today. Arriving at school is the same drill but a different day. With the mindset of getting through the day without any hiccups, I slowly ease myself into the hallways as eyes start to glare at me. My fingers scrunched within the tips of Nathan's black hoodie. With my hood up, I got to the locker to grab his textbooks. As I made my way to the first class, I shared Nathan's smile to anyone that would look, but not a single one shared it back. Sitting through history class, whispers of voices slowly crept in saying, "I miss the old you. You're still a kid. We ain't friends anymore. You'll understand when you're older." Nathan. Nathan. Nathan! Miss Gray screams. "Still thinking about your music? I see you have CDs in your hand." I didn't reply back, and instead took a CD and gave it to her. "What do you want to be when you grow up?" she says. while calling me out in the class. I start going through Nathan's head to find the right answer. I reply saying I want to be a rapper. She smiles and looks at me. Okay, that's a pretty nice dream, but you better get a real job. Is this real? Is this truly the way Nathan lives his daily life? Yesterday I was in a girl's body who was defined by her attractiveness, worrying about who was asking her to homecoming. Today, I'm fighting. I'm fighting with Nathan's inner thoughts. I'm fighting with Nathan's life. I don't want to be part of it, but I still have half of the day to go. The day slowly went by. The bell rings, indicating it's time to go home. Before walking out of Mr. Bryan's art class, he tells me that the midterm project is due next week. And he says, I know nobody is perfect, but I expect perfection from you. Before replying, a stream of memories came back. The old times when Nathan had a smile on his face. The old times when he was excited to be in class. Now that's nowhere to be seen. They used to be close, but when time passed, they became disconnected. I nodded my head and walked away. My sisters and I got off the bus to walk back home. As I held both of them by my side, the voices came back. Now, I learned to block it off. Feeling indifferent now, I just wanted to be the end. By the time I got to my room, I could barely function. I forced myself to finish Nathan's homework. Then I head to bed. I tried to sleep, but Nathan's mind didn't want to. He lays awake every night because his thoughts are relentless. I close my eyes to calm myself. If he didn't have music, what is he really left with?